What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to another video from Triple Deke Hockey. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the top moments of Sidney Crosby's career. Whether you love him or hate him, there's no denying he's given hockey fans their fair share of memorable moments, good and bad, depending on which side of the puck you're on. Stick around to the end and see which moment we think is his number one, and leave a like and comment below if you agree with the moments on the list. Coming in at number 10, Sid joins the Triple Gold Club. There are only 26 members of the Triple Gold Club, and to join, a player must win the Stanley Cup, an Olympic gold medal, and the World Championship gold. In 2015, Team Canada captured the gold medal at the World Championships with a 6-1 win against Russia in Prague, allowing Sid to join this exclusive club. Sid is the only player to achieve all three as the captain, and in the gold medal game, Canada outshot Russia 37-12, and Sid finished with a goal and assist. Overall, it's pretty remarkable accomplishment in being a member of this club before his 28th birthday. Fans in the media have been pushing for the Alex Ovechkin-Sidney Crosby rivalry for as long as both have been in the league. Admittedly, it's a fun rivalry, watching the Penguins and Capitals go head-to-head so often in the playoffs. Crosby and the Penguins defeated Ovechkin and the Capitals the first three times they've met, but it wasn't without fireworks. At number 9 on our list, Game 2 of the 2009 Eastern Conference Semifinals saw the two players go head-to-head in one of the most epic games you will ever watch, and likely the most exciting game played between the two players. In the end, both players recorded a hat-trick in the Capitals' 4-3 win, but it was the Penguins who won the best-of-7 series and went on to win the Cup that year. Let's lump two moments together for number 8 on our list. In 2007 and 2014, Sid won the Hart Trophy as league's most valuable player. Obviously, winning this award is a great honor for the player, but each of these has had special meaning. In 2007, Crosby racked up 36 goals and 120 points in just his second season, becoming the youngest player to take home the award since Wayne Gretzky in 1980. Winning the trophy for the second time in 2014, this one was special for different reasons. For the past few seasons, Crosby famously dealt with head injuries and lingering effects from concussions, missing over 100 combined games from 2010 to 2012. Coming back and scoring 104 points while earning the league's most coveted award in his first full season back was simply remarkable. At number 7, we have the concussion return game. Crosby spent 320 days recovering from the most closely chronicled concussion in hockey history. When he was finally able to return to the ice after missing 61 games, it took him less than 6 minutes to do what he does best. On his third shift, Sid flew through the neutral zone, took a pass from Pascal Dupuis, fought off a hook and burned by the defenseman before coolly throwing a sick backhand over the glove of the goalie, Anders Nilsson. What a vintage Crosby goal and a Crosby moment. After 10 months away from the game, Sid produced 2 goals and 2 assists in the Penguins' 5-0 win. The 6th top moment in Sidney Crosby's career came on February 16, 2017, when Sid scored his 1,000th NHL point in Pittsburgh against the Winnipeg Jets. Naturally, it came on an assist to set up a Chris Kunitz goal. Crosby reached this milestone in his 757th career regular season game, making him the 12th fastest and 11th youngest player to get to 1,000 points in NHL history. For context, Gretzky is fastest at 424 games, and Mario Lemieux is second at 513 games. He also was just the 86th player ever to hit this impressive milestone. At number 5, we have Crosby's 500th career goal, which came on February 15, 2022 against who else but the Philadelphia Flyers. Scoring this goal, he joined Alex Ovechkin as the only active NHL players to hit this milestone. He was the 46th player in history to score his 500th goal and second for the Penguins, joining Mario Lemieux. Sid has a history of torturing the Flyers, and his 500th was also the 50th he scored against them, the most against any team. Sid is known more for his playmaking ability, but he has led the league in goals in 2 different times throughout his career. As we know, the Penguins have won the Stanley Cup 3 times during Crosby's reign as captain. At number 4, we have his 3rd championship, the 2nd of the back-to-back wins in 2017. With this win, the Penguins became the first team in 20 years to repeat as Stanley Cup champs, defeating the Nashville Predators in 6 games. Crosby won the Conn Smythe Trophy again as playoff MVP, recording 27 points. His performance in Game 5 of the final may be what most remember him for during this run, as he was simply brilliant, with 3 assists in the Penguins' 6-0 rout of the Predators. For those of you that know Crosby's history, you may have a good idea as to what the top 3 moments will be, but for those of you that don't, stick around to the end and find out what we think is the best moment of Sidney Crosby's storied career. On June 12, 2016, exactly 7 years after he won his first Stanley Cup, Sid was once again on top of the world. At number three on our list, we have the 2016 Stanley Cup Championship win against the San Jose Sharks. Between his first cup win and this one, Sid overcame concussion problems that nearly derailed his career, two coaching changes, and a brutal start to the 2015-2016 season. After Mike Sullivan took over as coach of the Penguins, the team went on a remarkable run, winning this group's second Stanley Cup championship in six games. Sid finished off the postseason with 19 points and won his first of two Conn Smythe trophies as playoff MVP. Sidney Crosby's first Stanley Cup championship comes in at number two on our list. It's just wild how many storylines come up when talking about this cup win. To begin with, the final was a rematch with Detroit, who beat them fairly easily the prior year. On top of that, Detroit signed Marian Hossa, who spurned the Pens in the offseason by signing with Detroit instead of with them, citing he felt the Wings had a better chance at winning the Cup. Just like in 2008, the series started with the Wings taking a 2-0 series lead, albeit the games were much more competitive. The Pens ended up winning Game 7 2-1 on a legendary performance from Max Talbot and the rest of the team, as Sid suffered a knee injury early in the second period. Thankfully for him, he was able to make his way back out onto the ice and accept the Cup from Commissioner Gary Bettman. Sidney Crosby said he will never forget the moment. Neither will his native Canada, where his heroic effort is referred to as the Golden Goal. At number one on our list is Sidney Crosby's overtime winning goal in the 2010 Vancouver Olympics. 1 week prior to the gold medal game, Team USA beat Canada, so they had the confidence to beat the favored Canada once again. The game itself was played super tight, with Canada leading most of the way until Zach Parise scored with 24 seconds left in regulation. Heading into overtime, it was super tense, but almost 8 minutes into overtime, Sid took a pass from Jerome Iginla and the rest is history. Players and fans alike call it one of the best games they've ever been a part of or have watched. Just intense, highly skilled hockey the whole way through. What more does a fan want? And there you have it, hockey fans, the top 10 moments of Sidney Crosby's storied career. The top few probably didn't surprise anyone, but it's always fun to look back and relive these memorable moments. If you like the video, do us a solid and like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. Don't forget to leave a comment or two below as well and tell us your favorite part of Sidney Crosby's career. What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to another video from Triple D Hockey. Up next, we're going to talk about the greatest players to have ever worn every jersey number in the NHL. We'll break the list up into a couple of parts, so today we'll talk about numbers 00 through 20. Some numbers have been worn by multiple Hall of Famers, while others have only been worn a few times. Before we get started, don't forget to click that subscribe button, and don't forget to like, comment, and check us out on social media. Starting us off wearing 00, we have John Davidson. Only two players have ever worn 00, Davidson and Martin Baron, who only wore it for three games. Davidson wore 00 for the Rangers during the 1977-78 season, appearing in 34 games with an .899 save percentage. No player has worn 00 since, as the NHL banned it because their database couldn't register it. Only one person has worn 0 in NHL history, so he gets this spot by default. Neil Sheehy wore 0 for one season while with the Hartford Whalers in 1987-1988 season, registering a measly 5 points. Number 1 is one of those numbers that a bunch of goalies have worn, so for purposes of this list, we'll go with Johnny Bauer of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Bauer won 4 Stanley Cups, 2 Vezinas, and was an All-Star and Hall of Famer while playing through the 60s. Pretty solid choice if you ask me. Some other players to wear number 1 were Jacques Plante, Terry Sawchuk, and Roberto Luongo. Number 2 is typically worn by defensemen, and Brian Leetch was one of the best ever. Leetch was a 2-time Norris Trophy winner and first American-born Conn Smythe winner as playoff MVP for his incredible performance during the 1994 Stanley Cup run by the New York Rangers. He also won the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year while setting the record of 23 goals by a rookie defenseman. Eddie Shore, Doug Harvey, and Duncan Keith were also deserving of the top spot for number 2. Pierre Palat wore number 3 for the Chicago Blackhawks during the 1950s and 60s, where he won 3 straight Norris trophies and 3 additional runner-ups, along with a Stanley Cup championship while playing alongside Bobby Hall and Stan Mikita in 1961. While with the Blackhawks, he also served as team captain for 7 seasons. Honorable mentions belong to Gary Galley and Zdeno Chara. There is some stiff competition for the number 4 jersey, including Jean Beliveau, Vincent Lecavalier, and Red Kelly, but Bobby Orr takes the spot for us. Orr is widely considered the greatest defenseman of all time, who revolutionized the sport with his speed, scoring, and playmaking ability during his playing days in Boston. Orr played for 12 seasons and has the distinction as the only defenseman to win the league scoring title. He also won 8 straight Norris trophies and 3 straight Hart trophies as league MVP. As one of the greatest Swedes to ever play, Nicklas Lidström is the greatest player to wear number 5. Lidström played 20 seasons and was a 12-time All-Star, 7-time Norris Trophy winner and a Conn Smythe winner, and won 4 Stanley Cups with one of the NHL's greatest dynasties, while also being the first European player to captain a team to the Stanley Cup. The Red Wings never missed the playoffs during his career and was the first European named playoff MVP. Lidström was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2015. We have Phil Housley for jersey number 6. Housley was drafted 6th overall by the Buffalo Sabres in 1982. He played 21 seasons and is the second leading scorer in NHL history for American-born players, totaling 1,232 points, only behind Mike Modano, who passed him in 2007. Housley also never won a Stanley Cup, coming closest in 1998 with the Washington Capitals. Housley played for 8 different franchises and was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2004. Jersey 7 is also a number with a handful of Hall of Fame candidates, but our vote goes to Phil Esposito. Esposito is considered one of the greatest players of all time and greatest scorer of his generation, who played for the Blackhawks, Bruins, and Rangers during the 60s and 70s. He won 6 Rocket Richard trophies, 5 Art Ross trophies, 2 Hart trophies, and 2 Stanley Cup championships with the Bruins. He retired as the second leading scorer of all time in NHL history and was the first player in NHL history to score 1,000 points in a decade. Not too shabby at all. We finally have an active player show up on our list. At number 8, we have the great 8, Alexander Ovechkin of the Washington Capitals. Ovechkin finally was able to hoist the Stanley Cup in 2018, accomplishing the feat that eluded him for his entire career. Already considered one of the NHL's all-time great scorers, Ovi is on pace to challenge Wayne Gretzky's career goal record of 894 goals, claiming that record would secure his place in history as the game's greatest goal scorer. Number 9 likely has the most elite talent of any of the jerseys we'll look at. Part of this is due to the influence of the player chosen as the best to wear the number, Mr. Hockey Gordie Howe. Howe was the ultimate hockey player and inspired hundreds of future NHL players. Howe played 26 seasons in the NHL and another 6 in the WHA. He made his debut in 1946 and played until 1980, and led the league in points 6 times, goals 4 times, won 6 Hart trophies and 4 Stanley Cup championships. The Montreal Canadiens have quite the history, so to be the all-time leading scorer in franchise history, you have to be pretty special. Guy Lafleur is that guy, and the best to wear number 10. He totaled 1,246 points as a Canadian, and also played for the Rangers and Quebec Nordiques over the course of 17 seasons. He won 5 Stanley Cups and scored 50 goals and 100 points in 6 consecutive seasons. For jersey 11, look no further than Marc Messier. Messier was a highly physical player that also succeeded using his elite skill. Messier is a 6-time Stanley Cup champion and the only player to captain 2 different teams to Cup wins. The heart of the Edmonton Oilers dynasty of the 1980s and the man that led the Rangers to their first Stanley Cup win since 1940 in 1994, no 11 was greater than Messier. Jerome Iginla takes the top spot for number 12. Iginla is a 6-time All-Star, having twice scored 50 goals in a season. He's the franchise leader in points for the Calgary Flames, while also playing for 4 other teams throughout his career. Iginla also famously was never able to hoist Lord Stanley's Cup, but did have the primary assist on Sidney Crosby's golden goal in the 2010 Vancouver Olympics. From one franchise icon to the next, Mats Sundin is the greatest player to ever wear lucky number 13. Sundin is the Maple Leafs franchise leader in points, the first European player to be drafted first overall, and the only Swede to score 500 goals. Sundin was a silky smooth player and a fan favorite throughout his entire career. Number 14 was super close between Brendan Shanahan and Dave Keon, but Shanahan gets the nod here. Shanahan played in the NHL for 5 different teams, winning 3 Stanley Cup championships with the Red Wings. Maybe the greatest power forward to ever play the game, Shanahan accumulated 2,489 penalty minutes and 1,354 points spanning over 1,500 games. There surprisingly aren't too many household names that wore 15 in the NHL, but we're going with Milt Schmidt for the number 15. I'm sure many people don't know who he is, but he played through the 1940s and 50s. He won the Stanley Cup with Boston and a scoring title as well, but he also missed 3 seasons in the middle of his career after enlisting in the Canadian Army to fight in World War II. Number 16 has some very strong competition with the likes of Trevor Linden, Marcel Dion, and Bobby Clark, but Brett Hull gets the nod over them with his 741 career goals while wearing the number. Hull played for 5 franchises during his 20-year career and is one of 5 players to score 50 goals in 50 games. He won the Stanley Cup twice, was a 2-time Olympian for the United States, and joined his father Bobby in the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2009. Jari Kurri earned the top spot for us for number 17. Kurri had some tough competition in Ilya Kovalchuk, Wendell Clark, and Rod the Bod Brind'Amour, but putting up a ton of points playing along Wayne Gretzky puts him at the top of our list. Kurri played for 5 teams throughout his career, but found the most success during his time in Edmonton, where he won 5 Stanley Cup championships in his 10 years. He finished his career with 601 goals and almost 1,400 points, earning himself a spot as the first Finnish-born player to be inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame. Number 18 brings us to Dennis Savard. The Hall of Famer scored over 100 points 5 times in his career and won the Stanley Cup in 1993 with Montreal. Savard played for Chicago, Montreal, and Tampa during his career, but found most of his success in Chicago, ending his career as the 3rd leading scorer in franchise history. He has the unfortunate distinction of playing on a really good team during the Oilers dynasty of the 1980s, losing to them 4 separate times in the conference finals. Number 19 is one of those numbers with a ton of great talent, but unfortunately for the other players, Steve Yzerman also wore it, and is easily one of the best players in NHL history. Yzerman led the Red Wings for 22 seasons, serving as captain for over 1,300 games, winning the Stanley Cup championship 3 times and scoring an incredible 1,755 points during his career, which currently sits at 7th place all time. He's also won numerous awards including the Conn Smythe Trophy, Selke, and Lester B. Pearson. Notably, in the 1988-89 season, he scored a whopping 155 points, which was only bettered by Wayne Gretzky and Mario Lemieux for most points in a season in NHL history. While number 19 had a few Hall of Famers vying for the top spot, number 20 is no contest. Luke Robitaille easily claims the top spot as the highest scoring left winger of all time. Robitaille played for 4 different teams, winning the Stanley Cup with the Red Wings in 2002, but he's best known for the 14 seasons he played in Los Angeles. Lucky Luke finished his career with 668 goals and 1,394 points, which as mentioned is the highest point total in history for a left winger. And there you have it, hockey fans, the best players to ever wear jersey number 00 through 20. We plan to have future videos for the rest of the jersey numbers, so be on the lookout for those. But in the meantime, help us out and give us a like, subscribe, and follow us on social media. Do you think we forgot someone? Leave some comments below and let us know who should be included. What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to another video from Triple Deke Hockey. In this video, we're going to continue our series of the best players to wear every jersey number. In this video, we'll go through jersey numbers 21 through 40. Don't forget to go back and look at our last video that includes numbers 00 through 20. As you know, some numbers are much more popular than others, so choosing the best player isn't easy, but for some of them, it's a piece of cake. Before we get started, don't forget to click that subscribe button and like, comment, and give us a follow on here and social media. Starting off our list is number 21, Stan Mikita. There were a couple other good choices in Guy Carbonneau and Peter Forsberg, but when you're the Blackhawks' all-time leading scorer, you win. Mikita scored 1,467 points over his 21 NHL seasons and is generally regarded as the best center to play in the 1960s. In 1961, Mikita became the first Slovak-born player to win the Stanley Cup. Mikita was also one of the first players to use a curved hockey stick. The story goes that while he was hopping on the ice for practice one day, the stick got caught in the bench door, bending the blade. Soon he was borrowing the trainer's propane torch to create a curve on his stick. Mikita is one of the main reasons why there are rules in the NHL today about blade curves. At number 22, we have Mike Bossy, the greatest goal scorer of his generation. He scored goals at a crazy pace during his 10-year career with the New York Islanders and was an instrumental part of their 4-year championship run in the early 1980s. Bossy won the Calder Memorial Trophy as the top rookie in 1978, scoring 53 goals, and then won the Conn Smythe in the 1982 Stanley Cup playoffs. He also led the league in goals 2 other times and finished 2nd 3 other times. Bossy was also the second player to score 50 goals in 50 games and was elected to the Hall of Fame in 1991, having totaled 573 goals in his short career. For jersey 23, we have Bob Gainey. Gainey was the best defensive forward of the late 1970s, winning the Selke Trophy 4 years in a row from 1978 to 1981. Gainey spent his entire career playing for the Montreal Canadiens, also winning 4 Stanley Cup championships from 76 to 79. In total, Gainey scored just over 500 career points and was elected into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1992. Chris Chelios is another player whose resume sets him apart from the competition. He holds the record for longest career among defensemen, having played 26 seasons while also winning 3 Norris Trophies and 3 Stanley Cups, one with Montreal and 2 with Detroit. Chelios finished his incredibly long career having played for Montreal, Chicago, Detroit, and the Atlanta Thrashers. When he suited up for Atlanta, he became the oldest active NHL player and second oldest player ever, and is the former record holder for games played by a defenseman, while also holding the record for most playoff games played. Chelios was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2013 after he finally retired. Number 25 features a bunch of really good players, but no great ones. Because of that, we're choosing Joe Nieuwendyk for our Jersey 25. Nieuwendyk was drafted in 1985 and played 20 seasons in the NHL for 5 different teams. He has the distinction of being only one of 11 players to win the Stanley Cup with 3 different teams, winning with Calgary, Dallas, and New Jersey. Nieuwendyk also won a gold medal for Team Canada at the 2002 Olympics, Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year in 1988, Conn Smythe in 1999, and finished with 564 goals and 562 assists before entering the Hall of Fame in 2014. There was some strong competition at number 26 with Patrick Elias and Martin St. Louis, but Peter Stastny in his 1,239 points gets the nod here. Stastny played in the NHL from 1980 to 1995 and finished as the second highest scorer of the 1980s, behind only Wayne Gretzky. Stastny played for the Quebec Nordiques, New Jersey Devils, and St. Louis Blues over his career and currently ranks 34th all-time in NHL history for points scored. He was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1998. For those of you that don't know, Scott Niedermeyer has won a lot of trophies, and he's our pick for number 27. Niedermeyer played 18 seasons in the NHL and appeared in over 1,000 games for the Ducks and the Devils. He's a 4-time Stanley Cup champion and won the Norris Trophy and Conn Smythe Trophy in 2007. He's a member of the elusive Triple Gold Club, having won the Stanley Cup, World Championship, and Olympic gold medal, which he has done that twice. On top of all of this, he was also part of the championship teams in the 1991 World Junior Championship and 2002 World Cup of Hockey. Regarded as one of the top defensemen in NHL history, he was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2013. Before Phil Kessel and Patrick Marleau were the Iron Men of the NHL, that distinction belonged to Steve Larmer, who is our choice for number 28. From 1982 to 1993, Larmer played in 884 consecutive games for the Blackhawks, an NHL record for most consecutive games played with one team. Larmer had a chance to break the record, but a contract dispute ended his streak. Larmer received Selke votes 5 different times, but he never won the award and was part of the 1994 Stanley Cup champion New York Rangers team. There are a couple of current players that are potentially deserving of number 29, like Marc-Andre Fleury and Nathan MacKinnon, but we're giving the 29 sweater to Ken Dryden. Dryden won 6 Stanley Cup titles and even won the Conn Smythe Trophy and Stanley Cup before being credited with a regular season loss. After his Conn Smythe winning playoff run, his next season saw him win the Calder Trophy. He had a very short career though, playing only 7 seasons, but won the Vezina Trophy 5 times and finished with 258 career wins. He was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1983, and his number 29 was retired by the Canadiens in 2007. Number 30 has some pretty good competition for the top spot, but it has to go to Martin Brodeur. Brodeur stands as the all-time leader in wins, shutouts, saves, and games played by a goalie. He played 22 seasons in the NHL and also won 3 Stanley Cup championships and 4 Vezina trophies as league's top goalie. He won 2 Olympic gold medals with Team Canada in 2002 and 2010, as well as a few other medals during international competition. He won 30 games for 12 straight seasons and is the only goalie with 8 40-win seasons. Oh, and he also is one of 12 goalies to score a goal, but he did that 3 times. He was also elected into the NHL Hall of Fame in 2018. Have fun trying to top all of that. You could definitely make the argument for Grant Fuhr or Billy Smith, but we're going with Carey Price at 31. Price has been arguably the best goalie since his debut in 2007, highlighted by his 2014-15 season that earned him the Hart and Vezina trophies. He was so dominant in 2015, he won the Ted Lindsay Award, William M. Jennings Trophy, Vezina, and Hart, becoming the first goalie to win all 4 in the same year. In 2021, Price carried the Canadiens to their first Stanley Cup Finals berth since 1993, losing to Tampa Bay. He's also won numerous Olympic medals, including the 2014 Winter Olympic gold medal in Sochi. At 32, Dale Hunter gets the nod. Honestly, to know Dale Hunter is to look at these two stats. 1,020 points in a whopping 3,565 penalty minutes. He could score and he played rough, and just barely edged out Claude Lemieux for the top spot here. Hunter played for the Nordiques, Capitals, and Avalanche over the course of 20 years and holds the record for most penalty minutes in the playoffs. He's the only player in history to score 1,000 points and rack up over 3,000 penalty minutes. Number 33 has some pretty good players in Henrik Sedin and Zdeno Chara, but they don't compare to our choice, Patrick Waugh. Waugh revolutionized the butterfly style of goaltending, along with winning 4 Stanley Cup titles, 3 Conn Smythes, and Vezina trophies. He also is the only player to win the Conn Smythe trophy for 2 different teams. Waugh played for 19 years, 11 with Montreal and 8 for Colorado, winning 2 cups each. In 2004, a panel and fan vote selected him as the greatest goaltender in NHL history and was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2006. For the young folks watching this video, most of you would assume that we would pick Austin Matthews at number 34, and honestly, it's probably only a matter of time until he holds this spot. But until then, we're going with the Beezer, John Van Beesbrouck. Over the course of his 20-year career, the Beezer played for 5 different teams and won a Vezina trophy with the Rangers. After spending 11 years in New York, he was selected by the Florida Panthers in the expansion draft, where he helped lead them to their only Stanley Cup Finals appearance. He also played internationally for Team USA a few times and finished his career with an impressive 374 wins. Tony Esposito gets the nod for number 35. He is the only Hall of Famer to wear the number, so it only makes sense, right? Esposito played 16 seasons in the NHL, mostly for the Blackhawks. He won the Vezina Trophy 3 times and won the Calder Trophy in 1970 when he recorded an incredible 15 shutouts. He was also runner-up for the Hart Trophy that year. Esposito won a Stanley Cup with Montreal in 1969, but didn't play a huge part on that team. This one will be pretty quick, and a nod to Matt Zuccarello, but Matthew Barnaby gets the jersey for number 36. Most people probably know him for his fighting and enforced Misawa play, but he finished his career with over 300 points, along with a whopping 2,562 penalty minutes. Patrice Bergeron has become probably the best two-way player in the game today, and one of the best ever. As you likely know, Bergeron is the current captain of the Boston Bruins and is in his 18th season in the NHL. Bergeron has won 5 Selke trophies and the Stanley Cup with Boston, along with being a member of the Triple Gold Club. He's also won numerous medals internationally, playing for Team Canada. Bergeron also just recorded his 1,000th career point. Number 38 doesn't have any elite players to choose from, but has a few really good players. The late Pavel Dimitra is our choice for 38. Dimitra scored 304 goals in his NHL career, spanning across 16 seasons and 5 different teams, where he was a 30-goal scorer 3 different times and won a Lady Byng Award in 2000. After his playing career in the NHL, he signed with Lokomotiv of the KHL and was sadly part of the plane crash that involved most of the team in 2011. Dominik Hasek is the easy choice for number 39. Hasek played in the NHL for 16 years for 4 different teams and became one of the best goalies ever. His nickname is the Dominator for a reason, a 2-time Stanley Cup champion and 6-time Vezina Trophy winner. He also won 2 consecutive Hart Trophies as league MVP and led the Czech hockey team to a gold medal in the 1998 Winter Olympics. Hasek was best known for his distinct style of play and some called him a flopper, but whatever, it worked. He still holds the highest career save percentage and 7th all-time in goals against average. Not too bad for a flopper, right? And we have another easy choice here at number 40. Henrik Zetterberg spent his entire 15-year career in Detroit, scoring 960 points and winning the Conn Smythe and Stanley Cup in 2008. Bursting onto the scene as a rookie, he finished 2nd in Calder voting in 2003, won gold medals in the 2006 World Championships and Winter Olympics for Sweden. After his Stanley Cup win, he became a member of the elusive Triple Gold Club. He also served as team captain for the Red Wings during the final 6 years of his career. And there you have it, hockey fans, the second part of our Best Players by Jersey Number series, this time for numbers 21 through 40. Make sure to give us a like and a follow and let us know in the comments below which numbers you may or may not agree with. Also, be on the lookout for the next part, which will include numbers 41 through 60. And remember, it's a great day for hockey. What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to another video from Triple Deke Hockey. This is the third video in our series of the best players to wear every jersey number. Today we'll be looking at numbers 41 through 60, and to be honest, some of the players that make this list frankly aren't that great. If you want to go back and look at numbers 00 through 40, check the links below. Before we get started, give us a like and a follow. We've had some pretty good feedback on the previous two videos, so we're looking forward to seeing what you guys have to say about this one. We'll start off with number 41, and honestly, compared to a lot of the other players, it's kind of weak, but we're going with Craig Anderson. Anderson currently plays for the Buffalo Sabres, and at 41 years old, is the oldest active goalie in the NHL. He's played for six teams, but most notably the Ottawa Senators, where he holds a handful of team records. He's also won over 300 career games, and is the only goalie still in the league to have been drafted in the 90s. Number 42 is pretty much a toss-up between David Backes and Sergei Makarov, but we're going with Backes due to the longer, more consistent career. If we're talking hockey in general and not just the NHL, Makarov probably takes the cake, but we're keeping the list in the NHL only. Backes has played for 15 years in the NHL for St. Louis, Boston, and most recently Anaheim, totaling more than 560 points, and was named captain of the Blues during his time there. He also played internationally for Team USA and was part of the 2010 team that lost to Sidney Crosby and Team Canada in Vancouver. Number 43 is another weak player pool, so we're going with Martin Baron. You definitely could also make the case for someone like Nazem Kadri or Patrice Brisebois, but we're going with Baron. Baron played 16 years in the NHL, the first half with the Buffalo Sabres, then later stints with Flyers, Islanders, and the Rangers. In 2005, Baron won 13 straight games and ended up finishing his career with 230 career wins. Chris Pronger is the easy choice for number 44. He was the best shutdown defenseman of his era and the first blue liner since Bobby Orr to win the Hart Trophy, while also leading the Ducks to their first Stanley Cup win in franchise history. Pronger played 18 years in the NHL for five different clubs and captained three of them. He also appeared in the Cup Finals three times and, as mentioned, winning with the Ducks in 2007. He was also a mainstay with Team Canada for international play, winning Olympic gold medals in 2002 and 2010, becoming a member of the Triple Gold Club. After an incredible career, he retired in 2011 due to post-concussion syndrome. Number 45 is one of the weakest player pools on this list, so if you're an aspiring NHLer, maybe this is the number for you. For us, we're going with Aaron Asham as the best to wear it. Known for his tenacious playing style where he wasn't afraid to drop the gloves, he played 15 years in the NHL for six different teams, scoring 208 total points, reaching the Stanley Cup Finals with the Flyers in 2010 before losing to the Blackhawks. Here's another number with no elite talent, but rather some very good players. David Krejci gets the nod here. The Czech native has been part of the backbone of the Bruins for the past 15 or so years, playing a key role in helping them win the Stanley Cup in 2011. He led the NHL in playoff points in 2011 and 2013, and has played a bunch internationally for the Czech national team, most notably in the 2010, 2014, and 2022 Winter Olympics. Another weak player pool, another former Bruin. We could have gone with Alexander Radulov, Marc-Andre Bergeron, or a few other players, but our choice here is Tory Krug. Krug began his career in Boston and was the first Bruins defenseman to score in his playoff debut. He had a great run during the Bruins' 2013 Stanley Cup final run, turning it into a regular spot on the Bruins' blue line the following season. In 2020, he left Boston and signed a hefty free agent contract with the Blues. He's on his way to having a pretty solid career, starting this season with over 400 career points. We really wanted to go with Scott Young for number 48, but decided on Daniel Briere. Briere played for five NHL teams during his 17-year career, but is probably best known as one of the top Stanley Cup playoff performers of all time, registering almost a point a game in 124 playoff games. In 2010, he led the league in playoff scoring while helping the Flyers reach the Cup Final. He also represented Canada in a handful of international tournaments, earning a few gold medals. Briere finished his career with almost 700 points, topping out at 95 during the 2006-2007 season with Buffalo. Props to Joe Juneau for number 49, but we're going with Brian Savage. Savage played 12 seasons in the NHL for four different teams and wasn't particularly savage, but did finish his career with a respectable 359 points. He also earned a silver medal at the 1994 Winter Olympics and had a few noteworthy highlights, including scoring the first hat trick at the new Bell Center in Montreal in 1996. Not a ton of competition for the number 50 spot, so our choice here is Corey Crawford. Crawford played his entire 17-year career and won two Stanley Cup championships with the Chicago Blackhawks, finishing with 260 career wins, which are third most all-time in Blackhawks history. His 52 postseason wins are the most by any Blackhawks netminder, and he's also the only Blackhawks goalie to win multiple Stanley Cup championships. At 51, we had a tough time deciding between Franz Nielsen and Brian Campbell, but we decided to go with Campbell. Campbell played 18 seasons in the NHL for the Sabres, Sharks, Blackhawks, and Panthers, winning the Stanley Cup in 2010 with Chicago. He also won a Lady Byng Award in 2012, the first defenseman to earn the honor since 1954. Campbell last played in 2017 and ended up finishing his career with over 500 points. At 52, we have Adam Foote. Foote was one of the great stay-at-home defensemen of his generation while playing 20 seasons in the NHL for the Quebec Nordiques, Colorado Avalanche, and Columbus Blue Jackets. Foote won two Stanley Cup championships with Colorado, served as the captain of the Blue Jackets for three seasons, and won a gold medal for Team Canada in the 2002 Winter Olympics and 2004 World Championships. He's also the last active player from the Quebec Nordiques. There are a few good players to wear 53, but Jeff Skinner is our choice here. Skinner played 8 years with the Hurricanes, scoring 31 goals his rookie year on his way to winning the Calder Trophy. He was a solid offensive player for Carolina, but was traded to Buffalo in 2018, where he lit it up and hit the 40-goal mark for the first time. Coming into this season, Skinner has scored over 540 career points and holds the record amongst active players for most games played without a playoff appearance, which is obviously not a record you want. Number 54 has one of the weakest player pools on our list, with less than 60 players to ever wear the number. Our choice here is Adam McQuaid. The defenseman played for three different teams and was known for his physical style of play and capability as a fighter, often called on as the enforcer of whatever team he played for. McQuaid played for 512 career games across 11 seasons, winning the Stanley Cup with Boston in 2011. We're going with Larry Murphy for number 55. Murphy started wearing 55 when he moved to Pittsburgh and kept up the scoring and winning. He played 21 seasons in the NHL for six different teams, winning two Stanley Cups each with Pittsburgh and Detroit, both of which were back-to-back. When he finally retired, he held the record for most regular season games played by a defenseman with 1,615 and is currently fifth all-time in scoring for NHL defensemen. Murphy also made famous the Murphy Dump, as he would often flick the puck way into the air and into the opposing zone, clearing his own zone and also preventing the icing. Sergei Zubov wore number 56 once he left the Rangers, so he's our choice here. He's a two-time Stanley Cup winner with the Rangers and Stars and put up over 770 career points, 615 of which while wearing the number. While winning the Cup with the Rangers, he and a couple of the other players became the first Russians to have their names engraved on the Stanley Cup. Zubov was always a very solid player both offensively and defensively, but it wasn't until the 2005-2006 season he received his first and only Norris Trophy nomination. In 2009, he left the NHL and signed with SKA St. Petersburg of the KHL. David Perron gets the edge over anyone else for 57, mostly because there isn't a ton of great competition. But don't get me wrong, Perron has had a pretty good career. Perron was drafted in 2007 and played for six different teams, always seemingly ending up back in St. Louis, where he's had three different stints. He won the Stanley Cup in 2019 on his third stint with the Blues and currently has almost 700 career points and is nearing 1,000 games in his career. Chris Letang is the easy choice for us at number 58. He's been an integral part of the Penguins' core during the Sidney Crosby era and has four top 10 Norris Trophy finishes. He's won three Stanley Cups, scoring the cup-clinching goal for the Penguins in 2016 against the San Jose Sharks. Letang's in his 17th season, all with the Penguins, and holds pretty much all meaningful team records for a defenseman. At this point, he's been injured a lot, but he's still managed to play over 950 games in his career and has scored over 650 points. At 59, we have another easy choice, this time Roman Josi of the Nashville Predators. Josi is the current captain of the Predators and the first Swiss-born player to win the Norris Trophy as league's top defenseman. He's also the highest career-scoring Swiss-born player. Josi is in his 11th season, all with Nashville, where he's put up some pretty solid point totals, including almost a 100-point campaign last season, where he became the Predators' single-season point leader, breaking the record held by Paul Kariya. His 96 points last season was also the first time a defenseman has scored over 90 points since 93-94, but somehow he didn't win the Norris Trophy, finishing second, but he did finish 6th overall for the Hart Memorial Trophy. And last but not least, we have Jose Theodore at number 60. Again, not a ton of competition at 60, but regardless, Theodore deserves this spot. His 16-year career definitely had some ups and downs, but he had an incredible 2001-2002 campaign that saw him win the Vezina and Hart trophies, as well as leading the Canadiens to an upset of the top-seeded Bruins in the first round of the playoffs. He played for five different NHL teams and also played internationally for Canada. He's also been credited with scoring two goals and was the first goalie to directly score a goal and post a shutout in the same game. In total, Theodore finished his career with a respectable 286 career wins. And there you go, hockey fans, our third installment in the Best Player by Jersey Number series. I'm sure we'll have some differing opinions on some of these choices, so let us know in the comments below. Do us a favor and like, subscribe, and follow us on social media, and don't forget, it's a great day for hockey. What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to another video from Triple D Hockey. In this video, we'll continue our series with part 4 of the best NHL players to wear every jersey number. For the first 3 parts, check the links below. Before we get started, do us a favor and subscribe, like, and follow us on social media. We have had some awesome feedback, good and bad, regarding the choices in the first 3 videos, so we hope to hear from you again on this one. Now let's get started. First on our list is number 61, Rick Nash. Nash was selected first overall by the Columbus Blue Jackets in 2002 and played 15 seasons for them, the Rangers and Bruins. Nash was nominated for the Calder Trophy but lost out to Barrett Jackman. The next season, he tied for league-leading goals with Jerome Iginla and Ilya Kovalchuk, scoring 41 times. Nash finished his career having played over 1,000 games and scoring over 800 points. While he didn't win a Stanley Cup during his career, he did have a pretty solid international career playing for Canada, winning 2 gold medals in the Olympics and a couple other medals at the World Championships. Carl Hagelin is our choice for jersey 62, mostly due to the lack of competition. Don't get me wrong, he's had a solid career, but number 62 is definitely ready for the taking. The Swede was drafted by the Rangers and played for them, Penguins, Ducks, Kings, and Capitals. He's won 2 Stanley Cups with Pittsburgh and was famously part of the HBK line with Phil Kessel and Nick Bonino during their 2016 Stanley Cup run. Playing in over 700 games in his career, he's also appeared in the most playoff games of any player during the 2010s decade and won a silver medal with Sweden at the 2014 Olympics. 63, we have a controversial player. Not because of the debate if he belongs here, but because of the type of player that he is. Brad Marchand is our choice here, but again, there wasn't much competition. He's one of the biggest pests in the league and has been suspended a handful of times for his antics, but there's no denying the skill he possesses. At this point in his career, all spent with Boston, he's nearing 900 career games and over 800 points. He was also on the 2011 Bruins Stanley Cup squad and has won a handful of medals internationally for Team Canada. Michael Granlund gets the nod for us at 64, once again due to little competition. Granlund is a perfectly fine hockey player, carving out a nice career for himself, but definitely not on the top tier of players on our list. The Finnish center started his career in Finland and has played for Minnesota and Nashville in the NHL, now in his 10th season and scoring over 450 points in his career. He has also played a bunch internationally for Finland, earning a handful of medals. The theme continues at 65, another number without much competition. Erik Karlsson is our choice here. Even though he's quite deserving, he's been one of the best defensemen in the NHL for the past decade. Karlsson has played 13 seasons in the NHL and is currently with the Sharks, but before that spent 9 seasons with the Senators, where he won 2 Norris trophies as the league's top defenseman. He's well known for his speed and his ability to lead the rush, playing a ton of minutes every single night. He's nearing 700 career points and has played in a handful of international competitions for Sweden, including earning a silver medal at the 2014 Olympics. Where do we even begin for the next player? Sorry, Josh Hosang, but the only choice here is Mario Lemieux. Lemieux is one of the top 3 or 4 players to ever play the game and has been called the athlete with the greatest impact on his city for what he's done to the city of Pittsburgh. Honestly, a few blurbs about him doesn't do him justice, but let's try. To start, he won 2 Stanley Cups as a player and 3 more as an owner. He represented Canada internationally and finished his career with 690 goals and over 1,700 points. He once scored 5 goals 5 different ways in 1 game. He had to take time off due to cancer, but on the day of his last treatment, flew to Philadelphia and played that night. The list just goes on and on. Unfortunately, Lemieux was plagued by so many injuries, so there's no telling what other records he may have finished his career with. Someone in the comments of another video of ours said it best, that Wayne Gretzky probably had the better NHL career, but Mario Lemieux was probably the more skilled player. With a mediocre group at number 67, a former first round pick, Max Pacioretty, is our choice here. The former Montreal Canadiens captain has played for 3 teams, Canadiens, Golden Knights, and currently the Carolina Hurricanes. Pacioretty is into his 15th NHL season, having played over 800 games and earning over 640 career points. He's also represented the United States in international play and has earned the Bill Masterson Memorial Trophy for perseverance, sportsmanship, and dedication to hockey in 2012. Having one of the most incredible careers of any player in NHL history, Jaromír Jágr is our obvious choice for number 68. Jágr started his career alongside Mario Lemieux in 1990 and proceeded to win Stanley Cups the next 2 years, playing in the NHL until 2018 with a three-year sabbatical in the KHL. Jágr played for 9 teams, amassing over 1,700 games and 1,900 points, which is currently second all-time in NHL history. He holds a huge amount of team and NHL records, and along with his two cups, has won the Art Ross Trophy 5 times, the Lester B. Pearson Award 3 times, Hart Trophy 1 time, and is a member of the Triple Gold Club. He's also played extensively for the Czech Republic and has won a handful of medals as well. Andrew Desjardins gets the 69 spot by default. For some strange unknown reason, players have avoided using this number. Desjardins and Mel Engelstad are the only two players to ever wear it, and Engelstad did for only 2 games. Desjardins currently plays in Germany, but when he was in the NHL, he played for the Blackhawks and Sharks over the course of 400 games, acquiring only 64 points. 70 is another number with very little competition, but regardless, Braden Holtby would have it locked up. The 2008 draft pick spent the first 10 years of his career in Washington, where he won a Vezina Trophy in 2016 and the Stanley Cup in 2018, and then the Capitals won the William M. Jennings Trophy in 2017. After his time in Washington, he moved on to Vancouver and Dallas, but overall, he's played in over 500 career games with 299 career wins. Number 71 gives us another easy choice in Evgeny Malkin. Often taking the backseat to some other guy on this team that we'll see later on in this list, Malkin is a superstar in his own right and one of the best players of his generation. The Russian star has spent his entire career in Pittsburgh, winning the Calder, Art Ross, Hart, Ted Lindsay, Conn Smythe, and 3 Stanley Cup championships during his time there. He's also played extensively for Russia internationally and has won a bunch of medals during his career. Gino, as he's often called, is in his 17th NHL season, where he just hit his 1,000th career game and has scored over 1,150 career points. Number 72 was a toss-up between Sergei Bobrovsky and Patrick Hornquist, but ultimately the two Vezina trophies sealed it up for Bob. He's been one of the best goaltenders since making his NHL debut back in 2011, winning those two Vezinas while with the Blue Jackets in 2013 and 2017. Currently playing in Florida, Bob has played in over 600 career games and has won over 340 of them. He's also played internationally for Russia, winning a few world championship medals. Number 73 is another number with not much competition, so we're going with Michael Ryder. Ryder played 9 seasons while wearing number 73, putting up 431 points while wearing it. During his career, he played for 4 different teams and scored 8 goals in the 2011 playoffs while helping Boston win the Stanley Cup. We had a couple of solid choices at number 74 with TJ Oshie and John Carlson, but Carlson is our choice here. Carlson was drafted in 2008 by the Washington Capitals and has spent his entire career there, and has since blossomed into a star defenseman, having won the Stanley Cup in 2018 and being a Norris Trophy finalist a handful of times. At this point, he's played close to 900 career games and has over 600 points, as well as representing the United States in international play in the 2014 Olympics and 2016 World Cup of Hockey. Hal Gill, Walt Podubny, and Leroy Goldsworthy are the competition for our choice at 75, Ryan Reeves. We're going with Reeves mostly for the shock value his name brings. Reeves was drafted by the Blues in 2005 and has also played for the Penguins, Golden Knights, Rangers, and currently the Minnesota Wild. He's known for his enforcer playing style, fighting, intimidating, and protecting his players. He's been suspended a handful of times in his career, but has carved out a solid career, having played almost 800 games at this point. PK Subban stands way above everyone else to wear number 76. Subban played 13 seasons in the NHL for Montreal, Nashville, and New Jersey. In 2013, he won the Norris Trophy as the league's top defenseman and finished tied for leading scorer among defensemen. Subban has also played internationally for Canada, winning a gold medal in the 2014 Olympics. Subban finished his career playing over 830 games and scoring 460 points. Yes, Ray Bourque did begin his career wearing number 7, but he also spent 15 seasons wearing 77, so he's our choice here for 77. With the likes of Paul Coffey, Victor Hedman, and Phil Esposito, this number had some stiff competition, but Bourque is very deserving. He holds the NHL record for most career goals, assists, and points by a defenseman, and has won the Norris Trophy 5 times, and finishing 2nd 6 times. He's also finished 2nd for the Hart Trophy 2 different times, which is rare for a defenseman. Bourque won his only Stanley Cup in his last career game after being traded to the Colorado Avalanche for a Stanley Cup run. It seemingly rarely works out this way, but for Bork, it turned out to be the perfect ending. He played internationally for Canada and holds a ton of team and NHL records, so all told, finishing his career at over 1,600 games played and almost just as many points. 78 is absolutely one of the weakest player pools on this list, having only 7 players to ever wear it, so our choice here is Mark Pouliot. Pouliot began his junior career in the QMJHL and played on a line with Sidney Crosby prior to being drafted into the NHL. He ended up splitting his time between the AHL and NHL, finishing the NHL career with 57 career points. After being released from his final NHL contract in 2012, he began playing overseas and has been there ever since. Number 79 has had a few noteworthy players like Alexei Yashin, Michael Ferland, and Carter Hart, but we're going with Andrei Markov, mostly because of his consistency and longevity. After being considered one of the best defensemen in Russia, Markov was drafted by the Canadiens, where he ended up spending 17 seasons. He finished his career having played 990 games and had over 570 points. After his time in the NHL, he spent a few more seasons in the KHL and also played extensively internationally for Russia. And last but not least, we have number 80, going to Nick Antropov. Honestly, we've debated between Kevin Weeks and Antropov, but due to his consistency and longevity, we chose him. Antropov was drafted 10th overall by Toronto in 1998, which probably was a little too high at the time. Along with Toronto, Antropov spent time with the Rangers, Thrashers, and Jets. He finished his NHL career having played almost 800 career games and scoring 465 points before moving on to the KHL for a few seasons. The Kazakhstani Canadian also played in a handful of international tournaments for Kazakhstan. And there we go, hockey fans, the best players to wear jersey numbers 61 through 80. I'm sure there'll be some differing opinions on some of these, so feel free to let us know in the comments. Do us a favor and like and subscribe and check us out on social media too. Don't forget the links below for past videos of this series, and remember, it's a great day for hockey. What's up, hockey fans? Welcome back to our final part of the Best Players by Jersey Number series. So far, we've gone through numbers 00 through 80. Today, we're going to talk about numbers 81 through 99. Some of these will be obvious, but let us know what you think about some of our choices in the comments below. If you're enjoying the videos, please do us a solid and subscribe, like, and follow us on social media. All the links are below. Now let's get started. At 81, we have some great choices in Iron Man Phil Kessel or the devil himself Miro Shetan, but we're going with Marian Hossa. Hossa played for 5 teams and was a 3-time Stanley Cup champion, winning with the Blackhawks in 2010, 13, and 15. Hossa was known for a strong two-way play and was consistently among the top point scorers in the league. He was a 5-time All-Star and won the Mark Messier Leadership Award in 2010. He also played internationally for Slovakia, won a handful of medals with the team, but in 2018 he announced his retirement from the NHL due to a skin condition that made it difficult for him to play. He ended his career with over 1,100 points and over 1,300 games played and was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2020. 82 didn't give us anyone spectacular, but Martin Straka was a pretty good hockey player and our choice for the number. He played for 17 seasons and over 1,200 NHL games and scored 854 points. Known for his speed and goal scoring ability, he was a 3-time All-Star while playing for 5 different teams and even won the Lady Byng Award in 2000. In addition to his NHL career, Straka also represented the Czech Republic in international competition. He won a gold medal in the 98 Winter Olympics in Nagano and a bronze medal in the 2006 Olympics in Turin. Aleš Hemský is another one who benefits from lackluster competition, and he's our choice for number 83. Hemský played for 4 teams over the course of 15 seasons and was a 2-time All-Star. He is known for his offensive skill and playmaking ability and totaled 706 points in 845 career games. He also represented the Czech Republic a bunch of times in international competition, winning a gold medal at the 2010 World Championships as well as a bronze in the 2006 Olympics. Number 84 has had less than 10 players to ever wear it, and Mikhail Grabowski is the only one of them to score 20 goals 3 different times, so he's our choice here. Grabowski played for 4 teams over 11 seasons, finishing his career with 460 points in 646 career games. He was also a 2-time All-Star while also representing Belarus internationally. He never won a medal, but he's still considered one of the best Belarusian players of all time. Number 85 also had a small player pool, so Peter Klima gets the nod here. Klima played for 5 different teams over 13 seasons, finishing his career with 573 points in 786 games. He was part of the Oilers Stanley Cup team in 1980 and was a 3-time All-Star. He was a pretty good offensive player, scoring 30 goals 5 different times, and is third among Czech-born players in goals per game average. He's also represented the Czech Republic a bunch in international play, winning a gold medal in the 98 Olympics. Oddly enough, he was the first NHL player to wear number 85, and he chose it because it's the year he defected to North America. We have a pretty easy choice with number 86 in Nikita Kucherov. Kucherov is in his 10th NHL season with Tampa Bay and has developed into one of the premier players in the league. Along with the back-to-back Stanley Cups he's already won, he's also won the Hart, Art Ross, and Ted Lindsay Award in 2019. During the Lightning's Stanley Cup run, he led the league in scoring both times and holds the NHL record for most points in a season by a Russian player. At this point, he's over a point-per-game player, having played almost 600 games and accumulating over 660 points. There's obviously only one choice for number 87, the best player of his generation and likely one of the top 5 players of all time, Sidney Crosby. Sid the Kid was drafted by the Penguins back in 2005 and took the league by storm, and in 2007 was named the youngest captain in NHL history. At this point in his career, he's won just about everything a player can win. Along with his 3 Stanley Cups, he's won the Conn Smythe, Art Ross, Rocket Richard, and Hart trophies twice, the Ted Lindsay Award 3 times, team MVP awards, and a bunch of gold medals in international play, including scoring the golden goal for Team Canada in 2010. At this point, he's played in over 1,100 games and scored over 1,450 points. In his 17th NHL season, he's still among the league leaders in points and still dominating the game every single night. Check the link in the description below for our video of his top career moments. Patrick Kane is an easy choice for us at number 88. The former first overall pick has spent his entire career with Chicago, where he's won 3 Stanley Cups. Kane also was the first US-born player to win the Art Ross Trophy and Hart Trophy in 2016 when he led the league in scoring with 106 points. He's also won the Calder and Conn Smythe trophies and the Ted Lindsay Award. He currently leads all US-born players in goals, assists, and points, having played in over 1,100 games and currently sitting at over 1,200 points. He's also played internationally for Team USA, earning medals in the Olympics, World Cup of Hockey, and World Championships. Another easy choice for number 89, Alexander Mogilny. Mogilny played for 4 teams over the course of 16 seasons in almost 1,000 games, finishing his career with over 1,030 career points. He was definitely a goal scorer, scoring at least 30 goals 8 different times, and in 92-93 scoring 76, tying Timo Solani for league lead and setting a Sabres team record and NHL record for most by a Russian player. He won the Stanley Cup with New Jersey in 2000, becoming a member of the Triple Gold Club. Along with being a perennial NHL All-Star, he also played a lot of international hockey for the Soviet Union, earning a few medals. Number 90 gave us a couple of options, but we decided to go with Ryan O'Reilly. O'Reilly currently is the captain of the St. Louis Blues after having spent time with Colorado and Buffalo. He's nearing 1,000 games played and almost 700 career points. He cemented himself as one of the game's best two-way players, winning the Selke Trophy in 2019, along with the Stanley Cup and Conn Smythe. He's also played internationally for Canada, winning some World Cup of Hockey medals along the way. Number 91 comes at us with some awesome competition in Steven Stamkos, John Tavares, Vladimir Tarasenko, and one of the top Russians to ever play the game, and our choice for number 91, Sergei Fedorov. Fedorov played 18 years in the NHL, totaling over 1,200 games played and almost 1,200 points. Along with winning the Stanley Cup 3 times with Detroit, he also won the Hart, Lester B. Pearson, and Selke over the course of his career. Fedorov was one of the first players to defect from Russia to the NHL and the first European-trained player to win the Hart Trophy. He's one of the best playoff performers of all time, and while he played mostly center, he also played some wing and even defense. He also played internationally for Russia and finished his career as the top-scoring Russian of all time, but has since been passed by Alex Ovechkin and Gino Malkin. A few players were in the running for number 92, but our choice here is Gabriel Landeskog. After being drafted second overall in 2011, Landeskog went on to win the Calder Trophy and then was named captain of the Avalanche, at the time becoming the youngest captain in NHL history. He scored 20 goals in 9 of his first 11 full seasons, playing over 700 games and accumulating over 570 points. In 2022, he captained Colorado to their first Stanley Cup victory in over 20 years. Landeskog has also played internationally for Sweden, winning a handful of medals in the Olympics and other tournaments. Number 93 is again one of these numbers with a lot of good talent, like Peter Nedved, Jake Voracek, Johan Franzen, and Mika Zibanejad, but we're going with Doug Gilmour for 93. Gilmour played 20 seasons for 7 different teams, totaling over 1,400 games and 1,400 points. He won the Stanley Cup in 1989 with Calgary and was one of the best defensive forwards of his generation, winning the Selke Trophy in 1993. He holds Toronto playoff records for assists and points and scored an impressive 127 points in the 92-93 season. He only wore 93 for part of his career, but he was good enough that we're giving him claim to the number. Ryan Smith played for 18 NHL seasons, wearing number 94 for almost his entire career, so he's our choice here for the number. He spent time with 4 teams, but most of his career was with the Oilers. He was a Selke Trophy finalist 4 different times and played 1,270 games and scored over 840 points. He scored 30 goals in a season 4 different times and played internationally for Team Canada, winning gold on several occasions, but was not able to win the Stanley Cup during his career. We really thought about going with Alexei Morozov at 95, but chose Matt Duchene instead. Duchene currently plays for Nashville Predators, but spent time with Colorado, Ottawa, and Columbus. He's played over 900 games in his career and scored over 700 points, scoring 20 goals 8 different times so far in his career. He hasn't won any individual NHL awards yet, but has had some success with Team Canada on the international stage, winning some gold medals, including a gold at the 2014 Olympics. There's really only 2 options for number 96, Tomas Holmstrom and Mikko Rantanen. We're going with Holmstrom for the impact he had on his team during his tenure with Detroit. The Swedish forward played his entire career in Detroit, winning 4 Stanley Cups while there. He's most known for his incredible ability to screen the opposition goalie and for his physical net front presence. Holmstrom finished his career playing over 1,000 games and scoring 530 points, but what's weird is he actually scored more goals on the power play than he did at even strength. He scored 30 goals once in his career and won a gold medal in the 2006 Olympics playing for Team Sweden. If we were to put this list together 5 years ago, our choice here would have been Jeremy Roenick. Unfortunately, we're doing it now, so 97 obviously goes to Connor McDavid. McDavid was drafted first overall in 2015 to the Oilers and came in as the most hyped draft pick since Sidney Crosby a decade before him. McDavid has lived up to the hype though, scoring a ton of points and winning a ton of individual awards since joining the NHL. McDavid missed a bunch of time during his rookie season, so he missed out on winning the Calder, but the following year was named captain of the Oilers, becoming the youngest captain in NHL history. Since coming into the league, McDavid leads the league in scoring by a fairly wide margin. He's played over 500 games and has scored over 760 points already, along with winning the Art Ross Trophy 4 times, Hart Trophy twice, and Ted Lindsay Award 3 times. It's only a matter of time until we see him raise Lord Stanley's Cup. Only 3 players have ever worn number 98, so Mikhail Sergachev gets the spot here over Brian Lawton and Jesse Puljujarvi. Sergachev was drafted by Montreal 9th overall in 2016 and then traded to Tampa Bay, where he went on to win back-to-back Stanley Cups. The defenseman has reached almost 400 games in his career, scoring over 200 points. Sergachev has also played some international hockey for Russia, but mostly at the junior ranks at this point. One of the few numbers I don't think anyone will argue about, the great one Wayne Gretzky, is obviously our choice for number 99. There are few, if any, players more synonymous with a number than Gretzky. Since his number has been retired league-wide, there's no one that will be able to challenge him for his number. Gretzky played for 20 seasons in the NHL for 4 different teams and at the time of his retirement held 61 NHL records. He recorded over 100 points in 16 of his seasons, including 4 seasons of over 200 points. His 1,963 assists and 2,857 points are records that will likely never be broken, but his 894 career goals will likely be broken by Alexander Ovechkin in the next couple of years. Gretzky won 4 Stanley Cups, 9 Hart Trophies, 10 Art Ross Trophies, 2 Conn Smythe Trophies, 5 Lester B. Pearson Awards, 5 Lady Bings, and 3 All-Star Game MVPs, and played internationally for Team Canada. Honestly, Gretzky has so many accomplishments, we can't just list them all here. And there you have it, hockey fans, numbers 81 through 99, finishing out our series of the best players to wear every jersey number. Check out the links for the other videos in the series and leave us some feedback below, we love to see it. As always, help us out and click that subscribe button, and remember, it's a great day for hockey.